Okay, I'm Jeff Banks. I'm an extension agent for Utah State University here in Juab County. Today we're going to talk about drip irrigation and how you can conserve water by using a different method of drip irrigation around your home yard and in the garden. And the system is designed to use PVC pipe, Schedule 40 PVC, and ball valves and fittings. It's a system that is very easy to use, very user-friendly, easy to set up, and today I'm going to show you the basic details of this and show you how this system works. My system, I use 3/4-inch pipe all the way through, and that's kind of probably the choice of most people of using PVC pipe. The system is designed so anything in front of ball valves, in front of these ball valves, is all glued to handle the high pressure. I know people that'll have over 100 pounds of pressure in this main line, and so that's why you glue everything in front of these ball valves. But then after the ball valves, you don't have to glue in any of these, because once you open up the valves and with the holes in the lines that we'll show you in a few minutes, it reduces the pressure so you don't have to glue everything. So the way that you take care of these is the rows that you don't want to water, you have these little plugs that you just pull out and you push them back in, and then a plug that restricts the water from coming down those rows. So like this year, I've got several feet in between my squashes I'm going to have here. Okay, the secondary lines, your irrigation lines that we're going to want to just talk about briefly, is again all out of PVC pipe. You take these pipes, you do not glue them, you just dry fit them into these little tees. Okay, once it's all set up, a person can decide which way they want to have the holes up. Most people will put the holes down, will turn the pipe with the holes down, but some people like with the holes up. Just kind of a matter of preference. I like the holes down because the water will drain out of the lines. So if a person is going to use this with the holes up, what we recommend is about every 3 feet on the opposite side, they drill a little small hole, kind of a little drainage hole, that'll help drain the water out. Okay, one of the biggest questions we have on this system is what size of holes do you put in your irrigation lines? Different hole sizes have been tried, but the preference that we've come up with through the years seem to have the best result is a 1/16 inch. The first time I drilled all my holes, after I had them marked, I was down on my hands and knees on the lawn drilling the holes. And then the next time around, I had somebody suggest to me, you know, if you had some tables, you could set it up. It sure makes it a lot easier on drilling the holes. So that's what I've got here set up, and I want to show you. Okay, so you use a 1/16 inch bit. You don't need a lot of heavy duty equipment, a tape measure, and some kind of marking tool, and then a drill. The preferred method, okay, I get people asking me the question, like on spacing, how many holes do we put in? The thing that seems to work the best is when you're doing things like corn, peas, carrots, beans, these type of things, you drill a 1/16 inch hole every 6 inches. And then if you're going to do things like tomatoes, squash, these type of things, this will be personal preference on how far apart you have them. On my tomatoes, I like to have my tomatoes have a little bit of room, so mine are every 4 feet. Some of my squash plants are up to 5-6 feet apart. So what you do on that is you'll drill a group of 2 to 3 holes about 5 feet apart. So I want to show you how I like to do it. Like, I'll take my tape measure and I'll mark it out. I'd go the full length, whatever length I was going to go. And then, like, with just a little magic marker, I'll make, say, like, if I'm going to do it every 6 inches for like corn, these type of things. So I'll go along the whole length of the pipe and measure them. And then just with, like I said, some type of little drill, you just come in and you drill a 1/16 inch hole about every 6 inches. You want to make sure you don't go all the way through and drill a hole in the table, or you will get in trouble. Another thing to consider, and I was going to show you this right at the very first, is a lot of people that I've talked to, they drill their holes and then they talk to me about, well, their holes aren't lined up and they're kind of crooked. So what I suggest they do, you just take another one of your little tees that you've probably already bought somewhere, put a couple little pieces of, you know, like the pipe in there, and then go ahead and put that on the end And then as you go through and mark it, it'll hold that pipe still and won't roll back and forth. And I want to show you how I've designed my system to work on raised beds. Again, the same kind of principle. We have the main delivery line that goes along the edge of all my raised beds. And then I have my break off, or like secondary lines, like I mentioned in my traditional garden. And how I've designed mine is I've got three different rows in this raised bed. And my strawberry plants down here, they're designed a little bit different than what I have here. Like right now, I want to use my entire raised bed. So I've got like radishes planted already here. I got some peppers in the middle. And then on the outside, when the radishes are gone, I'm going to plant like some bush beans. But I've got, the way I've designed it is you don't water your peppers and beans and everything the same. So I've got three different ball valves, so I can irrigate three different ways in this raised bed. And on a raised bed, I have some people that want to use the entire bed. So another way to drill holes, besides just drilling a hole like on one side, is to drill a hole all the way through. So like on this raised bed here, and my strawberries are designed this way, I've got a hole that goes all the way through. I drilled through and I went every 3 inches. That way I can water from one edge of the bed clear to the middle, and then each of the rows I can water the entire bed. And I just want to show you what it actually looks like by using that system. Like when I'm just watering just right next to the pipe, that's what it looks like. It'll just come out. It's just a very small stream, more of a stream than actual drip system on it. And if I want to water even more, if say I've got a bed like my strawberries, when I do my strawberries, I'll turn the valve basically completely open, and then it'll cover from one side to the other, so I can irrigate the entire bed. For the best results of this, it needs to be pretty level. The main line doesn't have to be level, but your irrigation lines, they need to be as level as possible. They don't have to be laser level, but they need to be fairly level. And a way that a person can make changes, if your ground is sloped, put like some bricks or something underneath the lines, try to make them just as level as you can. You'll have much better success by doing that. We are down here at Nephi at a brand new community garden that we just developed this last fall and this spring. This is the first year of using it. We have 20 raised beds here. We designed this irrigation system after the same type of idea. Is the main line is the main distribution line, and it is all glued, and it goes all the way down this whole line. And then we have the break-off lines for each individual bed, and they can open and close the valves for each plant. And this is just another way that you can adapt this system to meet raised beds or other ideas. And by using this system, depending on what you compare it to, I'm comparing it to the test studies that we did versus like row or flood irrigating, we figured we were saving at least 75% to 80% water by using this little drip irrigation system. And I've had people in other places confirm the same thing, saying that they save up to 75% to 80% water compared to what they had been using. And we have a new fact sheet that was put online in May of 2012. It's called Designing the Basic PVC Drip Irrigation System. It's a fun little system to use, very simple to use, easy to design. We hope that you'll take a look at it, or you can look at other kinds of drip irrigation system. And if you have questions about this system, or if I can be of help to you on designing, or questions you may have, you can get a hold of me at jeff.banks@usu.edu, or you can get a hold of me at my office number at 435-623-3452. I hope this has helped, and have a great gardening season.